Today, I am going to discuss about Halwalkens and Halwarins. According to IPC system, it is called as Halwalken. According to common system, it is called as alkyl halide. Alkene means saturated hydrocarbons. Halogen group means it includes fluorine, bromine, iodine, and astatine. These are generally represented by letter X. So X is equal to fluorine, bromine, iodine, and astatine. Astatine is not taken into the consideration because it is radioactive in nature. It is radioactive in nature. Alkanes are highly stable compounds and least reactive compounds, but preferentially undergo substitutional reaction with halogens. Therefore, haloalkanes are the first and a fundamental class of derivatives of alkanes. Where one or more hydrogen atoms of aliphatic hydrocarbon, that is alkane, are replaced by halogen atoms, the compound formed are known as haloalkanes. The general form of alkane is RH. When hydrogen atom of alkane is replaced by halogen atom, then we can get haloalkane or alkyl halide or alkyl halide. Haloalkane or alkyl halide, where X is equal to, here X is equal to chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Astatine is not taken into the consideration. For example, methyl chloride, ethyl chloride, propylene iodide, etc. These are called as haloalkanes or alkyl halides. Similarly, when hydrogen atoms attached to benzene ring are replaced by halogen atoms, the compounds that are formed are known as haloarenes or aryne halides. This is the formula for haloarene or aryne halide. Hydrogen atom of benzene aromatic ring is replaced by halogen atom. Then we can get haloarene or aryne halide. Some common examples of haloarenes are chlorobenzene. This is the formula for chlorobenzene. Bromobenzene. This is the formula for bromobenzene. Iodobenzene. This is the formula for iodobenzene. These are called as haloarenes. Let us consider classification of haloalkanes. Depending upon number of halogen atoms present, haloalkanes are classified as monohaloalkane, dihaloalkane, trihaloalkane, tetrahaloalkane, etc. Let us consider some monohaloalkanes. alkenes. Monoyl alkene means it contains only one halogen atom. When one halogen atom is present in alkyne halide or haloalkane, then it is called as monohaloalkane. Some examples of monoyl alkenes are methyl chloride, ethyl chloride, ethyl bromide, ethyl iodide. These are called as monohaloid alkanes because these compounds contain only one halogen atom. That is why these are called as monohaloid alkanes. Let us consider dialkanes. Dialkanes contain two halogen atoms. That halogen atom may present on the same carbon atom or on the different carbon atoms. CH2, Cl, single bond CH2, Cl. Dichloroethane, dichloroethane, CH2, Cl2. Dichloromethane. These are dihaloalkanes. These are called as dihaloalkanes. These compounds contain two halogen atoms. Similarly, trihaloalkanes contain three halogen atoms. Tetrahaloalkanes contain four halogen atoms. etc. Let us consider halogens of this class. According to our definition, when one halogen atom is present in the benzene ring, then it is called as monohaloarenes. These are generally represented as chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, iodobenzene, etc. When two halogen atoms are present on the benzene ring, then these are called as dihaloarenes. Let us consider some dihaloarenes. This is the common class of dihaloarenes. It is called as ortho dihalobenzene. Ortho dihalobenzene. Some examples of dihalobenzenes are ortho dichlorobenzene, ortho dichlorobenzene, meta dichromobenzene, meta dichromobenzene, para diiodobenzene. Generally, in the benzene, according to the position of the first substituent, this is the first substituent, that is Z. According to the position of the first substituent, the next conjugated carbon atom positions are called as ortho positions. These are ortho positions. Ortho positions. Ortho position. These positions are called as metaposition. 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 Meta. Metaposition. This is the paraposition. The diagonal position is called as paraposition. P position. Position. So as per this concept, these are named as ortho dichlorobenzene, meta dichlorobenzene, para diiodobenzene. Let us consider classification of benzene on the basis of the types of hybridization of a carbon atom to which halogen atom is attached. Let us consider classification of haloarenes, haloalkanes, on the basis of types of hybridization of a carbon atom attached to the halogen atom. So according to this classification, according to this These are classified into following manner. Point 1. Classification based upon the nature of a CX ball. Classification based upon the nature of a CX ball. Here we consider the types of hybridization of a carbon atom. So already we know that when carbon atom possesses saturated bond, then it undergoes sp3 hybridization. When carbon atom forms unsaturated bonds, that means that may carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. Then when it contains carbon-carbon double bond, then it undergoes sp2 hybridization. When it contains carbon-carbon triple bond, then it undergoes sp hybridization. This is the concept of hybridization. When carbon forms singly bond, all bonds are singly bond, then it undergoes sp3 hybridization. When it forms double bond, it undergoes sp2 hybridization. When it forms triple bond, it undergoes sp3 hybridization. So according to the types of hybridization of carbon atom to which halogen atom is attached, these are classified into these are classified into alkyl halides or monohaloalkanes. That is the first class of sp3 hybridized carbon atom carrying halogen atom. In this case, halogen atom is attached to alkyl group. That means here halogen atom is attached with the alkyl group. Already you know that alkyl group means that may be methyl, ethyl, propyl, etc. All these carbon atoms are all sp3 hybridized carbon atom. Here halogen atom is attached with the sp3 hybridized carbon atom. In this case, halogen atom is attached to alkyl group. These are represented by the general formula, general form RnR. These are represented by the general form Rx or general formula CnH2n+1x, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. These are further classified into following manner. Depending upon the nature of carbon atom to which halogen atom is attached, haloalkanes or alkyl halides, monohaloalkanes or alkyl halides are classified into three categories. First one is called as primary haloalkane, primary haloalkane, alkanes or P alkyl halides. Second one is called as secondary haloalkanes. Secondary haloalkanes or alkyl halides. Third one is called tertiary haloalkanes or tertiary alkyl halides. Classification on the basis of nature of carbon atom to which halogen atom is attached. When the carbon atom is a primary carbon atom, then the alkyl halide or haloalkane is called primary haloalkane. Let us consider methyl chloride. Already you know that when a carbon atom is attached to the no other carbon atoms or any one carbon atom, then that is called as primary carbon atom. This carbon atom is called as primary carbon atom. Here halogen atom is attached to the primary carbon atom. That is why it is called as primary alkyl halide or primary haloalkane. This is called as methyl chloride. This carbon atom is called as P carbon atom or CH2Cl. This carbon is also called as 1 degree carbon atom. Depending upon the nature of the carbon atom, haloalkanes are classified as primary haloalkane or primary alkane halide. Let us consider secondary haloalkanes. When halogen atom is attached to the secondary carbon atom, then it is called as secondary haloalkane. When a carbon atom is attached to the two different carbon atoms, then such carbon atom is called as secondary carbon atom. Here, halogen atom or bromine group is attached to the secondary carbon atom. Hence, it is called as secondary haloalkane or secondary alkane halide. This class, methyl CH3 single bond, CH3 single bond HBr. 2-bromopropane. This is called as a 2-bromopropane. 2-bromopropane. Because bromo group is present on the second carbon atom of the longest chain, it is also called as propylene bromide. Propylene. Isopropylene bromide. It is called as isopropylene bromide. It is a secondary haloalkane. Then come to tertiary haloalkane. When halogen atom is attached to the tertiary carbon atom, then it is called as tertiary haloalkane. When halogen atom is attached to the tertiary carbon atom, here halogen atom is attached to the tertiary carbon atom, hence it is called as a tertiary haloalkane. When carbon atom is attached to the three different carbon atoms, here carbon atom is attached to the three different carbon atoms, that is why this carbon atom is called as tertiary carbon atom. Here halogen atom is attached to the tertiary carbon atom, hence it is called as tertiary haloalkane. Let us consider di. Let us consider 2-chloro-2-methylpropane. 2-chloro-2-methylpropane is called as tertiary haloalkane. CH3C, CH3, CL, CH3. This is the longest continuous carbon chain. Here, chloro-2 is attached to the second carbon atom, and also second carbon atom carries methylene. That is why it is called as, according to IP system, it is called as 2-chloro-2-methylpropane. This carbon atom is called as tertiary carbon atom or third degree carbon atom. Carbon atom. Hence, according to the nature of the carbon atom, monohull alkanes are classified as primary haloalkane or primary alkyl halide, secondary haloalkane or secondary alkyl halide, tertiary haloalkane or tertiary haloalkane. Then come to classification. On the basis of sp3 hybridization, second one is called as allyl halides. These are the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to an sp3 hybridized carbon atom next to carbon-carbon double bond. That means in this class of halides, halogen atom is attached with the sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and the next carbon atom is a carbon-carbon double bonded carbon atom. Then it is called as allyl halides. Let us consider one of the allyl halides, that is CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2Cl. Here, this carbon atom is the sp3 hybridized carbon atom. Because all the bonds are saturated bond, already you know that when all the bonds of a carbon atom is a saturated bond, then carbon undergo a double bonded carbon atom. Hence, it is called as alkyl halides or 3-chloropropene. 3-chloropropene. Or it is also called as, according to the trivial system, common system, it is called as alkyl chloride. According to IPSC system, it is called as 3-chloropropene. According to trivial system or common system, it is called as alkyl chloride. Then come to benzene halides, where the carbon atom is also sp3 hybridized. This is the third class of sp3 hybridized carbon atom, where halogen atom is attached. Benzene halides, these are the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to an sp3 hybridized carbon atom. Next one, aromatic. Already you know that benzene is a aromatic compound because it obeys Hockel's rule. That means it contains 4n+2 number of pi electrons. That is why it is called as aromatic compound or aromatic ring. Where the carbon atom is a sp3 hybridized carbon atom and it carries halogen atom. The next carbon atom must be aromatic ring carbon atom. That means where we represent the benzene on the basis of a structure, then it can be written as like this. This is the structural representation of a benzene. This is the graphic representation of a benzene. Here, hydrogen atom is replaced by CH3 group. Then it is called as a toluene. When one hydrogen atom of toluene is replaced by halogen atom, then it is called as benzyl halide. Benzyl halide. This carbon atom is a sp3 hybridized carbon atom. According to our definition, when halogen atom is attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and the next carbon atom must be aromatic ring carbon atom, then such alkyne halides are called as benzyl halides. This is the benzyl halides. Suppose we take, instead of X, we take bromo group, then we get benzyl bromide. This is the formula for benzyl. This is the formula for benzyl bromide. Next, come to the classification of haloalkanes or alkane halides or anion halides. On the basis of nature of CH bond, where carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Sp2 hybridized. Here the carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. That means this carbon atom must contain carbon-carbon double bond. Because when carbon atom contains carbon-carbon double bond, then this carbon atom undergoes sp2 hybridization. Let us consider this class of alkyl halides. First one is called as vinyl halide. First one is called as vinyl halide. These are the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to sp2 hybridized carbon atom of a carbon-carbon double bond. That means CH2 double bond CH2. This is called as ethylene. This is the formula of ethylene. According to IPA system, it is called as ethylene. According to common system, it is called as ethylene. Where one hydrogen atom of ethylene is replaced by halogen atom, then we can get vinylic halides. Vinylic halide. This is called as vinyl halide. Here the carbon atom is the sp2 hybridized carbon atom. When sp2 hybridized carbon atom carry halogen atom, then it is called as vinyl halide. This is called as vinyl halide. Suppose we take instead of X, we take chlorine, then we can get vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride. Then come to aryl halide. These are the compounds in which halogen atom is bonded to the sp2 hybridized carbon atom. This carbon atom is the sp2 hybridized carbon atom. And next, an aromatic ring. Then that is called as aryl halide or haloarine or halobenzene. Haloarine or halobenzene. This is the formula for haloarine or halobenzene. When one halogen atom of benzene is replaced by halogen atom, that means halogen atom is directly attached with the sp2 hybridized carbon atom. Here halogen atom is directly attached with the sp2 hybridized carbon atom. According to our definition, when a halogen atom is directly attached to sp2 hybridized carbon atom, that carbon atom must belong to an aromatic ring. Then that is called as aryl halide or aryl halide or halobenzene. This compound is called as halobenzene or halide benzene. This is called as haloarine or halobenzene. Chlorobenzene belongs to this class of organic compound. Bromobenzene belongs to this class of organic compound. Iodobenzene belongs to this class of organic compound. These are called as aryl halides or haloarines. These are called as aryl halides or haloarines. Next, come to the nature of a CX bond. Already you know that halogens are more electronegative elements than all the elements of a periodic table. Because when we move in a periodic table along a period from left to right, the electronegative value gradually increases. Halogens are the second last element of each period. That is why they have a high value of electronegativity. It includes fluorine with electronegative value 4.0, chlorine with electronegative value 3.0, bromine with electronegative value 2.8, iodine with electronegative value 2.5. If we compare the electronegative value of halogens with that of a carbon atom, generally halogens are more electronegative than carbon atom. Here, halogen atom is attached with the carbon atom through covalent bond. That means the shared pair of electrons between carbon and halogen is more attracted towards halogen atom as they possess higher value of electronegativity. Electronegativity means the tendency of an atom to attract the shared pair of electrons towards itself. This property of an atom is called as electronegativity. As halogen possess more electronegative value, that is why the shared pair of electrons between carbon and halogen is more shifted towards halogen atom. As a result, halogens acquire partial negative charge, that is called a small negative charge or delta negative, and carbon atom at the same time acquires partial positive charge, that is called a delta positive. That means this covalent bond is polar in nature. Polar in nature. Actually, there are two types of covalent bonds. One is called as non-polar covalent bond, another is called as polar covalent bond. When covalent bond is formed between two similar electronegative atoms, then the shared pair of electrons lies in between the bonded atoms. Then such covalent bond is called as non-polar covalent bond. But when covalent bond is formed between two dissimilar atoms of a different 20 electronegative values, then the second electron is shifted towards more electronegative value atom. That is why the more electronegative value atom acquires partial negative charge, and the less electronegative atom acquires partial positive charge. Then such type of covalent bond is called as polar covalent bond. That means CX bond is polar in nature. But when we move along the group from top to bottom, the electronegative value gradually decreases. That means the polarity gradually also decreases from top to bottom. The members of the halogen family starts from chlorine, bromine, iodine, and astatine. Astatine is not taken into the consideration. When move from chlorine to astatine, gradually electronegative value decreases. That is why the polarity decreases from top to bottom. So, more polar nature, CN bond is more polar, then CCl bond, then CBr bond, then CI bond. That means the bond length increases from top to bottom. As polarity decreases, bond length increases. That means CI bond is more than CBr, which is more than CN, which is more than CF. This bond length is very high. CI possesses high value of bond length. Then CBr, then CCN, then CF. That means CF is more polar than others. Let us consider isomerism of haloalkanes or alkane halides. Alkane halides possess chain isomerism as well as position isomerism. What do you mean by chain isomerism? Where same molecular formula represents two or more compounds which contain same functional group but differ in the carbon chain, then such compounds are called as chain isomers, and this phenomenon is called as chain isomerism. Let us consider the molecular formula C4H9Cl. This molecular formula can represent two chain isomers. One is called as linear chain compound. That is the linear chain compound. This compound is called as 1-chloro butane. This is a linear chain compound. With the same formula, we can write another compound, that is CH3. This is called as 2-chloro 2-methyl propane.